water. It's the foundation of life and the single most critical element in hydroponics. Get your water right and your plants will thrive. Get it wrong. And, well, let's just say your plants might start staging a tiny leafy rebellion. That's right, today we're diving into the science of water for hydroponics. How to test it, how to balance it, and how to keep it working for your plants. So let's dive in. In soil, plants have a buffer. They can pull what they need, and the soil itself helps regulate pH and nutrients. In traditional gardening, I was always told, the best farmers build the best dirt, and the garden takes care of itself. And that same idea is true in hydroponics. In hydroponics, the water is the growing medium. That means everything you're doing is trying to build the water up so that it grows the plants. That means its pH, mineral content, and purity all directly impact plant health. Small imbalances can lead to nutrient lockout, deficiencies, or even plant doom. And nobody wants that. I mean, imagine the horror of a lettuce leaf looking at you with disappointment. And now that you've imagined it, just know, I've had lettuce leaves look at me with disappointment. Before we even start testing our water, let's talk about the kind of water you should be using. Not all water is created equal, and some can cause you more problems than solutions, pun intended. Ideally, you want to use distilled water or reverse osmosis water. These are as close to pure H2O as you can get, meaning you can start with a blank slate and have complete control over your nutrient solution. Tap water, on the other hand, varies wildly depending on your location. Some municipal water supplies contain high amounts of chlorine or chloramine, which can negatively impact plant growth. If you're using tap water, let it sit out for 24 hours, or run it through a filter to remove these chemicals. But softened tap water, like what I have at my house, absolutely not. Softened water is loaded with sodium, or depending on your water softener, it could be potassium, but most of the time it's sodium, which is bad news for plants. Sodium competes with essential nutrients like potassium and calcium, leading to deficiencies and overall poor growth. If you're using a water softener in your home, pull water from a separate, non-softened source. These are normally like an outdoor spigot. Or you can do what I do, which I think is better, and you can go with distilled or reverse osmosis water. If you go with distilled or reverse osmosis, though, be sure that it's easy for you to keep up with your water needs. So, you know, I have a home distiller that we keep running almost all day long, and we just barely keep up with our water needs. So now, before you go adding anything to this high-quality H2O, you need to know what you're working with, and that starts with testing. When we're talking about testing water, we're talking about two key measurements, pH and TDS. We'll start with pH. pH tells us how acidic or alkaline the water is. Most plants prefer between 5.5 and 6.5. Outside of that, nutrients can become unavailable, even if they're present in the water, or you can get root rot. TDS, or total dissolved solids, is measured in ppm, or parts per million. This tells us how many dissolved minerals are in the water. Too low and your plants won't get enough nutrients, too high and they could suffer from toxicity. A good starting point for leafy greens is 600 to 800 parts per million, while fruiting plants like tomatoes often need 1,000 to 1,400. Think of it like you're making the perfect soup. Too little seasoning and it's bland, too much and you're basically chugging salt water. Once you know your water's baseline, it's time to manage it. If your pH is too high, you can bring it down using an acid like phosphoric acid. For me, this is labeled as pH down. If your pH is too low, a base like a potassium hydroxide or pH up can help balance it. But remember, when you're adjusting your pH, small adjustments are key. Add a little, mix well, and then retest. After adjusting your pH, nutrients come next, and we adjust the pH first so that the nutrients don't give us a false reading on the pH. Hydroponic nutrients provide the essential elements that plants need that we mentioned before: nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and some other trace elements. Always add your nutrients according to the manufacturer's recommendations, then test your TDS to make sure you're in the right range. Just a pro tip though, when you're first starting a new system and you've never done any TDS adjustment before, take a baseline TDS reading. Then add 1 milliliter of your nutrient solution, mix it up, and retest your TDS. That way, you know how much 1 milliliter of nutrient solution affects your TDS, and you can use that ratio to make adjustments later. Personally, I just write this measurement on a piece of blue painter's tape and I keep it on the side of my reservoir so that I know what my ratio needs to be. So, speaking of maintenance, water doesn't stay perfect forever. As plants take up nutrients and water evaporates, concentrations change, and that's why regular maintenance is key. And the key to regular maintenance is just a routine. My weekly maintenance routine looks like this. I check my pH and my TDS daily, and I adjust it as needed. Every day I top off with fresh water to maintain consistent nutrient levels, and I regularly do a full reservoir change. The frequency of it depends on what type of water you start with and how well you maintain it. For me, I use distilled water, so I start with about 30 parts per million, and I change my water about every 8 to 10 weeks. And there are probably some professional hydroponic farmers who are absolutely horrified by that admission, but it works for me. Also, keep an eye out for some signs of trouble. I'll do a video about frequently seen problems and how to address those later, but just some trouble that you can run into is algae growth, salt buildup, or unexpected pH swings. All of those can indicate it's time for a deeper clean. If your water starts to look like a swamp or smell like bilge water, it's time to hit the reset button. And a good rule of thumb is to fully scrub and clean your system every time you change out the water. Think of Monica Geller. There's no such thing as too clean. So that's it. Mastering water management in hydroponics is one of, if not the most powerful thing you can do to ensure your success. Get your pH and your TDS in check, manage your nutrients, and stay on top of maintenance, and your plants will reward you with rapid growth and incredible harvests. And let's be honest, there's nothing quite as satisfying as watching your plants thrive because you nailed the science. Who doesn't want to feel like some kind of wild alchemist growing food out of water? In the next episode, we're going to talk about the next most important feature, which is light. So be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. And remember, your plants may not be able to talk, but trust me, if you maintain their water, they'll thank you. Happy growing!